A guy who can barely put a damn sentence together is polling 10 points ahead of Senator Raphael Warnock out of the state of Georgia. Yeah, I'm talking about Herschel Walker. Let me remind you of how silly Herschel Walker actually is. Here's the first video.
You know, Senator Lewis, one of the greatest senators that's ever been. And for African American, that was absolutely incredible. How they been to throw his name on a bill of the voting rights, I think is a shame. First of all, you know, when you look at the bill, it just doesn't fit what John Lewis stood for. And I think they know that.
The late John Lewis was not a senator. That's what you're running for, Herschel. Did you know that? You're running for the Senate. Also, he said that John Lewis was against the John Lewis Voting Rights Act. The silliness of it all. But it doesn't stop there. Here's more.
I'll tell you something else I heard. Now think about this, because at one time science said man came from apes. Did it not?
Every time I read or hear that, I think to myself, you just didn't read the same Bible I did.
Well, what this was interesting though, if that is true, why are there still apes? Think about it.
No, Herschel, the reason why nobody agreed with you and that damn audience of silly ass people is because you were the dumbest one there. Yeah, I said it. Let's put it up. Charles Darwin's 1871 science altering book is what he was referring to. The book, The Descent of Man and Selection in Relation to Sex, the great naturalist and scientist mused on the theory of evolution, but he never, never said that humans descended from monkeys or apes or anything of that sort. Once again, he's polling 10 points ahead of Senator Raphael Warnock. Here's what Senator Warnock sounds like when he opens his mouth to talk about important things. Here it is.
Rather than adjusting their agenda, rather than changing their message, they're busy trying to change the rules. We are witnessing right now a massive and unabashed assault on voting rights, unlike anything we've ever seen since the Jim Crow era.
But Herschel Walker is 10 points ahead. Herschel Walker is even more than 10 points ahead of every Republican he's running against for the US Senate in the Republican primary in the state of Georgia. There's more. Republican US Senate candidate Herschel Walker is leading incumbent Democratic Senator Raphael Warnock by 10 points, according to a poll released Wednesday by a political action committee supporting the University of Georgia football great. This is called an internal poll. GOP Senate candidate Herschel Walker has boasted about graduating in the top 1% of his class at the University of Georgia. But recent evidence has come to light indicating that he actually did not graduate at all. Let me pause there. This man had that he graduated from college in his bio. He stated it during particular rallies, conferences, even when he was invited to speak on important committees to the United States government. They cited that he graduated top of his class from the University of Georgia. Not only did he not graduate top of class, that which is okay, he didn't graduate at all, which is actually okay. It's just not okay when you have made a career completely lying about it. Here's what that tells me about Herschel Walker. Herschel Walker is desperately trying to find validation. You were a superstar football player. You were one of the best football players in the history of the game of football. And you went around lying about a damn college degree. You're trying to fit in, right? You want certain people to say, Herschel is accepted. Herschel is smart. Herschel graduated from UGA, top of his class. And here's the irony of it. He's been saying this for years. Nobody from UGA said otherwise. They knew he never graduated. They knew it didn't add up. Not one administrator, not one college president, not one professor, not one student stood up and said, this man did not graduate from the University of Georgia. It continues. The survey of 2,500 registered Georgia voters put Walker at 51.4% compared to 41% for Warnock. The poll was conducted from April 3rd to April 16th via landline phones, cell phones, and text. This is a Virginia-based grassroots company. The company noted in a memo that Walker has built a double-digit lead despite the Warnock campaign blanketing the airwaves with more than $7 million so far in their ad spending. So what does that mean? That means that Walker can afford to look beyond next month's Republican primary to a November general election matchup with Warnock. The GOP frontrunner is polling well ahead of several other Republican Senate hopefuls whose combined support does not come close to matching his numbers. The grassroots targeting poll also found that President Joe Biden's approval ratings are on the decline in Georgia. Only 43.8% of voters surveyed approve of the job Biden is doing, while his approval rating among independents was even lower at 41.9%, according to the poll. The poll found Warnock's approval rating at 45.2%. The poll had a margin of error of plus or minus 1.96%. Now, I want to remind everyone, polls are not predictions. They are not. They are snapshots meant to be interpreted in an appropriate way. But this is a problem. There's no way a Herschel Walker, who will never do a debate, he has refused to do all debates. He will not do a debate in the primary. He will not do a debate in the general election. He will keep doing interviews where he sounds silly as hell and continue to poll well among voters. You know why? He's a Trump endorsed candidate. He's a controllable individual and he is their token. He doesn't know it. He thinks he's really running on some kind of wave of freedom, but he's not. It's fascinating that the polling numbers connected to Warnock, not just with this poll, but other polling data. He is anchored by the popularity or lack thereof of Joe Biden, the president of the United States. You see, this is why we've been screaming and shouting, Democrats in DC have to deliver. And when they don't deliver, other Democrats will suffer. That's what's happening here. All right, Jordan, thoughts?
Dr. Richey, I think you hit the nail on the head. The Republican Party wants Herschel Walker in part because he's controllable. He has been used by, you know, snake oil health companies for years as a spokesperson to shill, you know, just fake and scammy products that ended up losing millions of dollars due to mismanagement. He is very recognizable because of his football career. And they saw, look, we've got a tough competitor in Warnock. Like, it's that the Republicans are even in this position, I think, speaks to Warnock's strength, that he's even in that position. And also the organizing that Stacey Abrams and others put in to get out the vote in 2020. So they're really feeling the hurt there. So what did they do? Instead of running a Kelly Loeffler again, who is, you know, who committed insider trading while she heard her brief stint in the Senate, he said, let's get someone who can just run on name recognition. Doesn't have to be anything upstairs. Just people know him, like him because of football. And like, look, you're an SEC country. That works. And I think they saw it with Tommy Tuberville. They see it with Herschel Walker. I would not be surprised if the Republicans in the South, if they're in a tough position, just keep running SEC legends. Because it's as sad as it is, that's all you need. People will see the name, recognize them, check the box.
Yeah. So damn sad. We're going to continue to follow this to the Warnock campaign. Wake up. Okay, see what's happening.